Now that we have admin seated to the database, we can go ahead and log in one of them so we can start building it out. So admin at admin.com password. What we can do next is create a new dashboard page just for the admins. So what we would do is go into our text editor and we'll go to a new terminal and then we'll create a controller. So it'll be PHP artisan and we'll create a make controller and the folder we'll call it admins and then admin dashboard controller and then we'll make it resourceful. Okay, so while that's doing that, let's head over to our web.php file and add that root there. So what we'll need to do is create a group for it. So we'll leave this one alone since that one is mainly for our normal logged in users. Okay, we'll just say route middleware. Okay, and then we'll use the auth sanctum. And we can also use the verified. And then we'll say name. And the common name we're going to have for all of them is admin dot. Before the middleware, we can also put a prefix. So prefix and that prefix will also be admin. Okay, so at the end of this, now we can add group and then function, some curly braces, open that up, and then we can add that new route in here. Okay, so it'll be route get. We'll say dashboard and the route, the controller will be admin dashboard controller class and then we'll use the index function and we'll just name this one dashboard. So then we'll head up top and make sure that that controller has been imported. So now we can go to it, admin, dashboard, controller, and then we can create the inertia render in here. So return, inertia, make sure we import it up top, and it's right here. Okay, so render. And it'll be admin dashboard and that'll be the name of our page. Okay, so let's go ahead and create that page now. We'll head down to resources, JS, pages, and we'll create a folder and the file here. So it'll be admin dashboard.view. Now in here, well, we can close this terminal for now, and then we'll say template. We'll just do H1 dashboard, and then we'll add our script tags, and we'll leave it at that for now. Okay, so let's go to the browser and make sure that we have that route. So now this will be admin dashboard. Okay, great. So now we have dashboard up here. Let's head back to the terminal. And I want to put around, basically, if you go to the user, the regular user dashboard, there's this app layout in here, which we can actually copy. And we'll paste it in our new template. Okay, and let's make sure to import the app layout. Import app layout from in its layouts app layout. Okay, and this is coming from our layouts folder and our app layout right there. Okay, and we also need to add the component here. So components, app layout. So this is importing the welcome component, but let's go ahead and take a look anyway, just to make sure that we're getting that here. So go back, refresh. Okay, and now we have the app layout and this says dashboard, but we'll fix that in a bit. If we head over to the layout, the app layout, okay, we need to do some cleanup in here. So the first thing that I want to do is take out anything involving teams, which would be this whole teams dropdown. Can get rid of that. Settings we can keep. Can keep all this stuff here. Okay. Showing navigation, keep that. Go down. Okay, here's another team management section. We can get rid of that. And then that's pretty much it. We can also take out this method because we're not going to be using that. So now we can close the admin dashboard controller. And now we have these two to work with. So what I want to do is I want to create another layout file for our admins. Okay, so we'll just take this one and we'll add a new one here into the layouts folder. So it'll be admin layout.view. And in this file, we are going to add some template tags. We are going to add app layout. Open that up. Add some script tags. We'll open that up. Okay, and in here, we can just add a div with the classes of flex, flex, wrap, space, y6, py6. On the small sizes, we want justify around, and on small, we want space y0. Okay, open that up. And then here we want a div with the classes of BG white, overflow, hidden, shadow XL, py6, width full, small width 2/3. Small, we'll say rounded large. Okay, open that up. Okay, that's not working well. Okay, so we'll try this again. 2/3, small, rounded large. Okay, now we need this to be a div. And in here, we're just going to add a slot. Okay, and this will be where all of our admin pages are displayed to. So we also need to import the app layout from at layouts app layout. And then we also need our component section app layout. So now in our dashboard page, we can change this app layout to admin layout. We can change these imports to admin layout. At up top, okay, this can be now admin dashboard. And in here, we need to change this div. It will now be PX6, PY2, and now we can just put some lorem ipsum text in here. So lorem, and that should be good. Let's head back to the browser and see what we see. So go back, refresh. Okay, great. So we see our lorem, but we managed to have lost our title. So let's head back to the text editor and we can grab it from our app layout because there's one in here. So we can just take this, copy, head over to admin layout, and we can add it right in here. So paste. Yeah, that should be fine. Let's check it out. Go back, refresh. Okay, fantastic. So now we have our title back and our main admin layout is in place. I'm going to leave it there for today, guys. I'm going to go ahead, push this up to GitHub, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.